when you think, that's just incredible. That's like, that's what I mean. That tweet, if he actually said that, I'm blocked. Like, that really show, I mean, that again, like what's happening here is you're seeing stuff said from MSNBC land that is as delusional as stuff you hear on Fox. Like, that is not just wrong. Like, that is demented. I mean, like, honestly, like, okay, here's the tweet. Mike Bloomberg, Tyler Perry. All right, we're already off to stupid land. Tyler Perry, George Soros, Bob Johnson, Bernie Sanders, Bill Gates, Mitt Romney, Donald Trump, Papa John, Mark Cuban, Oprah, and Jay-Z. Yes, all these people and more can be legitimately described as oligarchs, but outside of a scholarly conversation, I wouldn't bother.
Yeah, that's scholarly discussion. Thank you, Dr.
Johnson. Let me just tell you something. I want to say, Dr. Johnson, just as you're able to project yourselves in the heads of people who work for a minimum wage, I'm going to project myself outward and say, most people will not consider that a scholarly conversation. And I do think, okay, I don't know the net worth of everybody on this list, but I think it is, before you even get to like some of the meaningful distinctions that may exist between varying levels of political influence and what industries these people are in, let's just take one thing, which is basically one person on this list is worth a couple million dollars. Everybody else on this list is worth, like, I think at a bare minimum, like, I think probably, Trump is probably almost certain. Trump claims to be a billionaire. I probably don't believe that. I think Jay-Z is worth at least 400 million. I mean, he's up there. Is Oprah a billionaire?
Oh, yeah, I think
Oprah's
so.
A billionaire.
Yeah, definitely.
So, and Tyler Perry, okay, Tyler Perry is probably worth
600 mil or something.
600. Like, Tyler Perry is an extremely successful director and businessman. So, I mean, basically, he just put, like, I mean, this doesn't even work either, because Bernie is like in his late 70s and finally made money from writing a book. But if we wanted to be scholarly about, I mean,
a book about his political beliefs.
A book about his
political beliefs. So he's being rewarded for that. Like, right? Like, that's the political influence. It's already there. That's why he's a millionaire.
He put the Chapo Trap House Patreon page on a list with George Soros and Mike Bloomberg. Like, yeah. I mean, honestly, like, I can't even, this is just so, this is what I mean. Like, this isn't even wrong. This is just like, this is not a person who's fit to think. This is not fit for purpose. This is insane. This is the type of thing that we would play someone say something like this on Fox and go, Jesus Christ, they're lunatics. Yeah. That's an insane comment. That's insane.
Samuel Finkelstein has added the net worths to this.
This is an insane comment.
I mean, that's a good academic discussion.
It's a great academic discussion. Wait, so read some of them off.
So Mike Bloomberg, 60 billion dollars.
Mike Bloomberg's worth,
you were
60.
Right about Tyler Perry off the top, though. Just
I think I saw it, actually. George Soros, 8 billion. Bob Johnson, 1 billion. Bernie Sanders, 2 million. It makes 2 million look so tiny.
I know. It's like 2 million. Like, what is, like, Bernie Sanders is like toiling in like a little like watch repair shop or something.
Bill Gates, $110 billion.
Oh, it's all the same.
Mitt Romney, $250 million.
All
Donald
the same.
Trump,
less than Papa
I don't
John.
Believe
it. Wow.
Trump, $2.5 billion. That's a lot.
Yeah, I don't know about
Papa
that.
Papa John, $500. Mark Cuban, $4.1. Oprah, $3.5. Jay-Z
hit a billion.
Hit a billion, yeah, I remember that. Yeah.
So basically, like, and literally you're, okay, so basically, and you know what's, again, in addition to how delusional, embarrassing, and insane, and just demented, and I can't emphasize embarrassing enough, this is actually, like, the way this gets weaponized is that this is the, I'm going to make oligarch an irrelevant term in the same way that right-wing people make poor an irrelevant term, which is, well, they've all got refrigerators. You know, people in the richest people in ancient Rome didn't have phones. Ergo, poor people don't exist. I mean, I don't know. I can't, like, honestly, like, how can you walk around in public and put, like, And this is a tweet. So theoretically, you actually had a time to look at it
yeah.
and say, do I really want to write something this embarrassing?
He's really like approached levels of posting through it yeah. that we haven't seen in a long time. And before this, I think we had it on the show yesterday where he said, like, if I'm making like minimum wage, the difference between $1 billion and $1 million means nothing to me. And like, maybe functionally that's true, but like, that is a huge difference in inequality in this country.
Well, I think what he maybe should have said, I don't know the man's salary, but maybe if he said, hey, I'm making $500,000 a year to be a propagandist for mediocre Democrats, $1 million and $1 billion doesn't make a difference to me. Maybe he should have said that, because I would seem to be much closer to his area of expertise.
Somebody's made the multipliers of this. Bill Gates has 36,667 times the worth of Bernie Sanders. So Bernie's just got to write that many more books.
Yeah.
And he too can be an oligarch on exactly. level with Bill Gates.
I need to write Where Do We Go From Here at least 10 a day. And they all need to be bestsellers, God, or else my secret plan won't work.
Can we just collate a bunch of my old speeches and put those out?
Jesus Christ.
Just plagiarize Dems. We don't get these things shipped.
It worked for Biden, sort of.
If I just write 100 more books, I can reach the next person on this list.
I look at that list and I think we could catch up with Mitt Romney with a little bit of hard work.
I mean, I just appreciate Jason Johnson moving in so forcefully and taking over the billion poster for billionaires position. Like, he has completely monopolized that.
No, that is amazing.
In a way that I'm sure they can all respect.
Yeah, and all, because it's like, I really appreciate it, because Nina Turner had some very basic questions about me having $60 billion and how it affects our democracy. And Jason Johnson came up with this brilliant point, which is that when you really think about it, that's actually the only part that would offend somebody like Bloomberg. You're saying that my $60 billion is the same as this fucking old hippie's book? How dare you?
He's not.
I built an empire. He just wrote some shabby little book that a bunch of useless hippies wrote. Anyways, I don't have time for this anymore. The people of Ohio, no more e-cigs. It's honestly, it is one. Obviously, we have very different politics, but we're the notion, I think, that especially people in our position wrote on, that there is some level of sanity, competence, and coherence in the other side of this battle in the Democratic Party. I mean, I guess not.